Hello and welcome to the Brain and Transcranial Photobiomodulation Virtual Summit. I'm Dr. Joe Dodaro, your host. I have with me my guest, Dr. Leonardo Longo from Florence, Italy. As a little background, he got his degree in medicine and surgery from the University of Florence in the year 1980. And his honor thesis was the experimental study on the histopathological effects of laser radiation. He also obtained a specialization in endocrinology in 1984, where his thesis was the preliminary considerations on the use of lasers in the hormone level regulation. He's the director of the Florence Laser Symposium, which he's going to talk about, that he's been running for years. And I have to say that it's my great pleasure to have you here with me today. Go ahead, Doc. Do you see the picture?
Yeah. Very nice.
Very nice. This is us from a long time ago. Now we both have a lot more gray hair.
And about the, 10 years,
The thing is that this was in 2011. You were talking about, you presented there, the only person talking about the nervous system that I recall at the NALT seminar in Wisconsin.
Milwaukee,
Wisconsin, and your work has been fundamental in using the lasers on the nervous system, the central nervous system. So tell me about that. You're the first person to actually put those lasers, you know, on the nervous system. Tell me about that.
Yes, I continue to use laser on nervous system for a lot of mechanism of action possible on the regeneration of the nervous system. At the first, we have the anti-inflammatory mechanism. Laser can arrive on nervous system with inflammation, and the remotion of the inflammation give a decompression of the nervous system. So this is very good, because nervous system need to work without compression of edema or without compression of enlarged cells, etc. And then when we remove the inflammation, we have the second effect, the regeneration. The regeneration caused perhaps directly by the light, perhaps also indirectly, because we move a series of chemical reaction, of energy reaction, and so the system can change the its asset, and we can have, for instance, glial nervous system, which is transformed in a functional nervous system. And this was demonstrated by Bethesda.
So you said you started back in, that's good with the light, turn the light on. That's good. So you said you started back when you did the Laser Florence in 2003, you had a plenary session with experts from all over the world, and they started this whole idea about the interaction between light, laser, and the nervous system. That's what got you going, right?
Of course. The all the results shown in that conference were absolutely demonstrated, absolutely scientific. But when we use the laser on the human body, we have some problem of statistical of the evaluation, absolutely scientific, for a cause very simple, that two lesion on the nervous system of the man are never the same.
Each are lesion, what? Are what, Doc?
When we speak about the lesion of the central nervous system, we cannot have neither two lesions same.
Equal. Two lesions aren't the same. When we deal with a human in the nervous system, two lesions aren't the same, correct?
Yes, this is a big limit of the rigid protocol of the statistical calculation, because the variable of the variability of the parameters is very, very large.
Correct.
So we put the statistic, is always relative, never absolute. And this is a big limit, not only for photobiomodulation, but for all the therapies, all the diagnosis of the lesions of the nervous system.
This is a very good observation.
Yeah.
Would you like to share your slides?
Oh, I would like to show the summarization of all the effects demonstrated on cell level about the biochemical effects of laser modulation. All the names are the names of the first authors which show this and published on peer review. So increasing the dose of light radiation from in a window from a visible until the near infrared light of wavelength, we have progressively activity mitochondrial increase, the nucleic acid synthesis increase, protein synthesis increase, enzymatic activity is modulated, and we have also the change of the pH. All these biochemical effects are cause the a series of histological effects of laser modulation. And increasing the dose, we have at first active hyperemia, then modulation of cell activity, increase the number of mitosis, the dilatation of cytoplasma, and the first three histological effects are effects of biomodulation of the regeneration. If we increase the dosage, we go versus surgical effects and side effects for the biomodulation.
I want to be clear here. Yes. So in the histological effects, the first three, which you have in yellow, active hyperemia, modulation of cell activities, an increased number of mitosis.
Yes.
What kind of effects did you say?
Effect of photobiomodulation, active hyperemia, modulation of cell activities, increased number of mitosis of the cells. So at the first we have microvascularization increase, at the second the cell activities increase, and the number of mitosis of cells increase, for instance, unbounded.
And then the green ones are the negative effects, if I'm correct, what you said?
Yes. In green are, for photobiomodulation, the green effects are negative effects.
Okay.
If we would like to go at cellular level, it's very interesting this possible general mechanism proposed by us and wrote in 2003, sorry. And so the mitochondrial activity, we always say the mitochondrial produce energy, it's really, but also wall of the cell produce energy. Also the other components of cell produce ATP, cytochrome, etc. But mitochondrial produce only mitochondria, so it's specific. Another activity of the mitochondria, the production of the water. When the mitochondria produce one molecule of water, immediately start the production of ATP of the whole cell.
Of the whole cell?
Yes, of all cell. When the cell is damaged, mitochondria don't produce normal water, but peroxide of hydrogen. The peroxide of hydrogen give a little amount of ROS, reactive oxygen species. Reactive oxygen species, when are in few quantity, clear the cytoplasm of the cell. So the cell damaged is regenerated, and the cell come back versus is versus her function. Then, when the damage of the cell is very, very important, the peroxide of hydrogen don't arrive to recover the cell, and mitochondrial bring two oxygen ions and give oxygen free, singlet oxygen. Singlet oxygen coagulate the cytoplasm, the cell is killed. But the cell killed stop the possibility of degeneration of the cell versus neoplasia, versus teratogenesis, etc. Light and laser could modulate all these processes. And these effects are strictly dose dependent.
Very good.
So he, I give a list of effects already demonstrated by my friends and other authors as neuroregenerative and neuroprotective. We would like to dose laser for increase massive axonal sprouting, survival times, synthesis of various molecules such growth factors, calcitonin, etc., etc. Proliferation of cell of swan in the rat, all this demonstrated. Macrophage and fibroblast activity increase. And we would like to decrease the nitric oxide, because nitric oxide activity is no good for the cell, for the nervous cell. And the chromatolysis and the atrophy of the motor neurons would like to decrease. And in effect, light enhance recovery of neurons from injury by altering the mitochondrial oxidative metabolism. So when we would like to speak about the hypothesis of action mechanism, we must remember the anti-inflammatory antidema effects. We must remember the hyperemic effect, the modulation of the stem cells regeneration, because with Juanita Henderson and Wayne and Hillev, we demonstrated that the stem cells irradiated with laser increase the proliferation, the migration, the differentiation of them. So we have also the stimulation of neural cell function. And this is last but not least, the modulation of bioplasm. Bioplasm is a layer of energy between the body material and the energy around the body. It's accepted from the National Health Institute of USA only from 2004, but in other countries the bioplasma was now accepted many, many years before. All this mechanism can be responsible of the action contemporaries are synergic.
Can I say, Doc, that can you go back one second? Oh, the human energy field. Go ahead. This is what I want to talk about. Go ahead. Perfect.
The human energy field. Human energy field was now not in 2004. It's now in 7,000 years before Jesus Christ. It's called aura and chakra in India, in Armenia, in East Asia and Europe. And the prana was the energy around the body in all the world. We swing in the prana. So in China, in many years before Jesus Christ, the same cosmic energy was called the Qi, and Yin Yang, the mechanism of interchange between human body and the external. And John White, scientist of Los Angeles, investigated 97 QR cultures, old cultures, and he noted 97 different names for to indicate the same things. In 20th century, we call the prana the cosmic energy, aura, always aura, and there is the bioplasma, and there is the chakra. Chakra are now called by the physics coherence domain.
Coherence domain, thank you.
Yes, the coherence domain are the windows of better interchange between the energy of external of the body and energy internal. So we speak about quantum energy, human energy field, coherence domain. We change the name, but the concept is always the same.
Always the same.
So we have a lot of system for to measure this energy. One of the system is Killian effect, light of different wavelengths concentrated in set in different layers called auras around the body. The chakras or coherence domain are the windows of interchange. Each wavelength seem corresponding with a body system organ. And it seems also that an organic change could change the features of corresponding aura with an interval of about 1 month. And this is important for the prevention. Seems that laser and light radiation modify selectivity, all these colors, all these auras. And the limitation, unfortunately, is that we can perform a quality measuration, but not a quantity measuration at this moment. So it's possible only measure some features, not all the features. And the measuration give problems because this misuration must be performed in total dark and possibility in absence of gravity. This is no good, no possible at this moment with this system, with the Killian. And perhaps in near future, laser light radiation could be used as prevention and therapy of many diseases. And this is the map. The map of human energy field and of the anatomy of energetic system. This map is only a picture, but the energy is dynamic. And Professor Konstantin Korotkov from St. Petersburg University had 2 years ago the nomination for Nobel Prize because he performed, he made a camera for to measure to look the auras and the domain of coherence dynamically. It's very nice this. On the left you can see myself with my energetic asset in 1997. Perhaps now is absolutely different.
I can see the Bapo was brown. You see, Bapo is brown. I thought that was you, but the Bapo is a mustache. Yes, brown.
Exactly the same. But this misuration was performed in Orlando, in Florida, in American Society of Laser Medicine and Surgery many years ago. And this is another system of misuration, not camera Killian, but another type. This image are for courtesy of Padua University for my friend Professor Pedersoli. And you can see the bioplasma. Bioplasma is this. In the bioplasma there are light from 200 nanometers until 2500 nanometers. Wow. And this is the asset of the auras of the same subject with normal subject without pathology. This is another subject with aura absolutely good, without any disease. When we would like to have the energetic asset with the diseases, you can see this woman with a lot of diseases. We treated with a cycle of laser therapy for scapulohumeral periarthritis left, and after the cycle, you can see the difference. And the light of laser arrived all on the arm, left arm. And after 20 days, this all this light arrived in the matter.
Arrives in the muscle, will go down to the muscle, to the tissue.
Yeah, on the tissue. Oh. If you read all the books of physical therapy, all the books say the results of all physical therapy can be summarized definitively about 20 days, 1 month after the end of the cycle. In all the book is wrote this for electrostimulation, tense, laser, magnetic field, etc. Nobody say what this, why. Why is because all types of energy, not only light energy, need 20 days, 1 month, for arrive in the matter. From the energetic anatomy, arrive in the matter atom, in the material. The same asset is valid for the vegetables, as the flowers, for the animals. The case. So at this point, come back versus the nervous system. We treat patients following always the same criteria of inclusion and exclusion. Inclusion, patient of both sex, age young or middle until 6 years ago, 6 years old, sorry. Deletion occurred 1 year ago and more. We can see the deletion with the instrumental diagnosis, with nuclear magnetic resonance, TAC, etc. And we can see the total and subtotal lesion of central nervous system. When we use classification, ASIA classification, we can have a group A or group B maximum. No therapy device, and the top drugs progressively. And we continue with the rehabilitation in associational laser. In exclusion, surgical intervention contra nature, no improvement after first cycle of laser, use of drugs not prescribed by us, or some patients stops the physical therapy, and we stop also this. So, before the treatment with laser of some central nervous system injuries, we must remember some concept, general concept. At first, similar central nervous system lesions give always different loss of function and answers to the therapy.
In response, yeah. The lesion will cause a different loss of function,
yes,
and a different response to the therapies.
Yes, of course. Okay. Three different variables for to make a statistic. But we have three variables before to start. It's impossible. anatomy and the function often are dissociated. Also, this is one example. Lesions are not totally measurable and not reproducible and not repeatable, unfortunately, on the man. On the animal, we can, but on the man, is no, it's hard to obtain this. So for the diagnosis and the therapy, we must remember that the statistic criteria are not totally valid because there are much variables. So when the lesions are also always different. So protocols are always relative, never absolute. We must adapt the protocols to the patients, not the patients to the protocols.
Amen, that's correct.
And this is the summarization of all our treatment. We use three different types of laser, three different wavelengths. One laser with two different dosage, and each laser have a different penetration, different action. As you can see, we use laser not for transcranial modulation with CASC or similar, but on the coherence domain of nervous system.
The coherent dominance of the nervous system. So yes. To let the, just for a little context, if I could jump in, you're dealing with a lot of this research was involved with spinal cord injury people.
Yes. Right? Yes.
And so these people, you can't, if someone has a motorcycle accident, you can't say, okay, now we need another guy to go down the same road and hit the same tree like you did and break your spine, because these people were, a lot of these people were paralyzed, right?
Yeah. But we use laser for the radiation direct on the spinal cord injuries, directly on the zone of the lesion, but after also on the domain of coherence of nervous system.
Ah.
But when we have brain injuries, we use laser for the radiation only of the coherence domain. Not
coherence domain.
Yes, coherence domain. There are three coherence domain principle on the cranial region, but only three. The other are on the rest of the body. Understand? Oh, this is the little summary of our activity. We treated 305 patients with spinal and brain injuries. Only with brain injuries, a few patients, only 10 patients. And the majority had the spinal cord injuries. But there are some function also in the spinal cord injuries which depend by the brain. For instance, the reflexology of the anal sphincter. When we treat this patient, we can read on the books that of the literature that the anal sphincter and anal reflexology could return spontaneously only within 1 year and a half after the lesion, and never when the lesion is total. Okay? This is wrote on all the books of neurology, physiotherapy, etc., etc. So we selected 57 patients with total lesion, total spinal cord lesion, age, middle, young, both sex, and Total spinal cord injury was demonstrated by the fact that the vertebral fracture had also a dislocation. So the colon and the medulla was totally crazed. So we treated all patients with lesion occurred minimum 2 years before the treatment. And they had a total absence of anal sphincter function, anal sphincter reflexology. So these are the results. On the anal sphincter, we had on 57 patients, 53 patients, which had the return of the anal function and anal reflex, quite normal. And the follow-up of 2 years, but now is for somebody also 3 years of follow-up, is positive, absolutely positive. We have also the control. As you can see on the graphic on the left, on the control, nobody had some function on the sphincter. Nobody, zero. And so the results are absolutely incredible. Unfortunately, we don't have the same luck with the ureter sphincter.
The urethral sphincter. But yeah. That is, when you've talked to your colleagues about these results, that's pretty amazing. Did they believe that? Do they believe that when you tell them that? I mean, without a full dissertation? Everybody says it's never coming back. The function will never return. And yet you returned over 90% of the normal function.
Yeah. Yes. I think it's a little revolution, this. Because this is incredible. Also, because we don't have the... the wording of the lesion. When we continue, I can give what I would like to say. So this is the schema, the list of all the results. On this list, we say that the sensation is positive results when the sensation sensitivity come back for minimum 2 metamer levels below the lesion, because 1 metamer only can be a spontaneous phenomena, but 2 no, 2 or 3 no. And so we have a lot of results positive in involuntary motor. Involuntary motor depending by the physical therapy, and for the sexual therapy, which come back quite always, not to ureteral function, but sexual function, yes. Stand up on 300 patients, 171, and 45 work. Work not normal, work with the tutors, with some problem, etc., but work. And the ASIA change about 1 degree each 6 months. And we have, with instrumental diagnosis, disappear after about 60 sessions, edema and inflammation, but lesion of medulla reduced, but don't disappear quite neither. This is another mystery. The dynamometer, etc., evoked potential, etc., improve, minimum 2 muscles enrolled more each 2 cycles. And electroencephalogram, the same. We have a progressive improvement.
Now, I want to go back 1 second, Doc, because I want to push one thing. that the people who, when you give the more intense, description of your people, of your clients, of the patients that you studied, volunteers and such, these are very, very damaged spinal cords.
Yeah.
The spines are destroyed. And the people are paralyzed. They can't, like you saw where they started from the top of the head to the middle of the neck, all the way down. Yeah. And the not only the changes that you were able to document here, we see this in black and white, but the quality of life changes of these people to get their life back and to be less of a burden on their family and society, and to be able to function more. I mean, that was one of the greatest eye-opening things that I've ever witnessed.
It's a very, 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 very good, a very satisfaction for the patient and for us. I treated a lot of patients of different diseases, but the best satisfaction I had with this type of patient. One question is, the improvement of these patients could be spontaneous or caused by other therapies, as physical therapy alone, or cost-effect ratio between laser and results is not controlled, is not scientifically demonstrated. Or follow-up, how much is long the follow-up? Or side effects, complication? I have some answer at this question. At first, 39 patients stopped the laser treatment for 3 years and more for personal reasons. And when they come back to continue laser photobiomodulation, here, the situation of these patients was the same than the moment they stopped the treatment. So the follow-up was positive, as always. And once they restarted the therapy, the improvement restarted too. So there is some link, I think, between the therapy and the obtained results. Side effect complication, only some skin burns, first degree, exceptional. At the first patient, not much exceptional, because we must remember that this patient have always prosthesis, metal prosthesis for to link the colon, the bone.
That's and correct. So
We must pay more attention, not irradiate directly that, because the laser come back and we have the epidermis burn. Complication? No, I don't have neither complication. And this is a very interesting case, because this patient, man, had a total lesion, ACA, etc., in 2006, the lesion 2 years before. And we treated this patient with about 134 sessions. And you can see this patient, which stand up and start the work. This in 2007, but computerized tomography show always the same lesion. Until October 2011, when it had a column of new tissue with partial welding of the lesion. So we have a dissociation.
So take your pointer, take your mouse, and show me with the where we're looking at here, so that I can see this. So there's the T12, there's the fracture, I see it. Right there. That's the spinal cord. coming up.
Yeah, this is the plaque, the metal plaque.
Uh-huh.
A new tissue, because this is the lesion.
Uh-huh, there it is.
Without the scission, without the tissue, only with the plaque.
Got it.
We don't see the tissue. So,
wow.
Another situation, totally different. But results arrived 4 years before the new tissue. So our result caused by other mechanism.
Mm.
This is another patient, T10, T11 lesion ACIA, total lesion, 35 years old, without arm right. So he had also spastic paralysis with pump, with major relaxant. With laser, I arrived after 76 irradiation. The spastic syndrome disappeared totally. After about two months, the pump was removed. And I removed about 10 pumps.
Wow.
And he stand up after 88 sessions. He don't can perform some little movement. Brain traumatic lesions. For instance, we had this patient with brain traumatic hemorrhage at temporoparietal region in 1988. This patient had the coma for 4 years, two neurosurgical intervention for subdural hematomas, and the convulsion spasticity for 10 years. He came in my consulting room after 20 years. After 20 years, he had the total right motor hemiplegia, partial right sensory hemiparesis, right facial paralysis, dyslexia, dysphonia, and the electroencephalogram, total absence of normal activity on left hemisphere, maximum on temporoparietal region. And he had the low comprehension, low expression, and loss total of memory. Edema right arm, right hand, leg, and foot. I used the laser photobiomodulation with this dosage, the same dosage of the first schema, only on the coherence domain and right hemiface and the limbs. And the same laser with different dosage, only on the full coherence domain.
3 sessions a day.
Yes. Now I perform also 4 sessions, but 3 sessions a day with a minimum 2 hours of interval between the sessions. In opposite, we have overdosage, the opposite. The electroencephalogram control before laser treatment, left temporoparietal diffuse sufferance without change under stimulation. After 198 application, we had left focal temporoparietal sufferance with ASVER under stimulation. At this point, the patient said to me, "I understood you better." So I given a journal and I said, "Please read." He read. After I continues, he had the return of the memory. He was an engineer.
Oh.
He remember the mathematics. I understand. So I continued, and he had also the sexual stimulation. He would like to go alone for a walk for without the parents, but parents are not disagree this, unfortunately. So the summary of results is that this patient is another person, totally another person. Another patient exceptional was a patient with Locked-In syndrome. This patient had the complete paralysis of voluntary muscles in all parts of the body, except for those that control A movement. In this patient, only left A was normal. The right was totally blocked. The fracture of basal of the cranius was total. He had the problem 3 years before my intervention. I treated only coherence domain with two different dosage, only with diodes, and results of only one cycle, 20 applications. He had the control of both AS, facial paralysis quite disappeared, voluntary movements of mouth, total sensory function of the body, tactile thermopressor and postural, and voluntary movement of arms and legs. Fortunately, I don't continue with this patient for problems in the family with girlfriend and other personal problems.
Certainly.
Depression. So, until today, the persistence of the result are controlled. So I treated also further patients with other sensory nervous system disease, not only traumatic disease, as progressive leukodystrophy, only 2 patients, cobalt neuropathy, facial paralysis, a lot, and Space syndrome, and multiple sclerosis. But multiple sclerosis, unfortunately, have follow-up negative. I have results, but the results remained only for some months, 1 month, 2 months, maximum 3 months. Then the patient come back, have a bad situation, or it's not possible to perform a lot of applications each 3 months. It's no ethic, I think.
Got it.
We must make perhaps some little lasers. Only for the patients.
Correct.
But unfortunately, multiple sclerosis have a lot of different clinical variations. And this is another exceptional case because this woman don't have facial nerve, congenital paralysis, Bell paralysis. And I treated with laser. As a parameter of evaluation, I have the symmetry of the face, the possibility of close or not close the hay, the possibility to have enlarged expression or no. As you can see, after 40 sessions, I had very good results with follow-up very positive. These are the treatment dosage. Another exceptional case of facial nerve disappeared for surgical intervention of angiosarcoma of the oral cavity. This patient was totally blocked, but after laser, this patient had very nice results, as you can see. We divided the results of further about 50 patients with facial syndrome, and We have divided the results in excellent, good, less. When the parameter symmetry A close, not close A, and enlargement possible, we have excellent results. Two parameters good, one parameter less, or no results. And the results was positive in the majority of cases of the patients. The group grit was the group two, not the group three.
The good results. You can see that on 30 people.
Not excellent,
but 15 were excellent, correct.
Conclusion, we can say that the laser photobiomodulation traumatic central nervous system injuries gives positive results using more wavelength contemporaneously. These results could be measured with more systems and tools associated with synergic effects. Some anti-inflammatory and regenerative effects of lasers on human body are demonstrated. The action mechanism includes surely the effects of biophotons on the human energy field. The procedure of radiation is very important because the effects are strictly dose dependent. The dosage depends by a series of parameters, physics, clinics, biologic, and energetic. And another fact very important, the coherence. The coherence allows the exact dosage of laser light on the tissue. So we can establish what kind of effect do we like to obtain. And this is a series of reference, bibliographic reference, because some bodies say, ah, but the references are very little. No, it's very large reference, not very little. We need to read all these references. And this is the book of my friend Michael Emblin, where I wrote the chapter of central nervous system injuries traumatic. And this is one idea about a master in laserology. We organized in Italy with the University eCampus from Milan. And this master is 70% virtual. Only 30% with front lesion. And at the first in September, we had the master in Italian language. But in January, we would like to have another master in English language. Ah. And this is my friend Theodor Maiman, the creator of Laser, with his book Laser Odyssey. Very nice. My motto, love the truth and work hard to affirm it. And the creators of Laser Florence conference, the next Laser Florence will be in November 21. And this is the last Laser Florence poster.
Rainbow of the laser medicine. Well, thank you so much, Doc. Now, I'm not going to let you go without a couple questions.
Yeah.
Thank you for that presentation. You've done so much work in this field. But, you know, one is your theory, because you're kind of looking at it, what is your theory of the influence of the light energy that we're putting into or onto the body and how that works with the biofield? What is your perspective on that? Share that with us.
Yes, the influence is very, very, very large, because we need the energy for to organize the matter, you understand? Mm-hmm. When we would like focalize all our therapy on the matter, we had we perform a thing wrong because we don't use the possibility to obtain more, understand? Because, for instance, for the treatment of brain injuries, we don't need the irradiation of all cranic zone, because laser arrived maximum immediately under the bone, but not arrive laser on deeper in the central nervous system, okay? But if we give the energy, light energy, on the coherence domain of the brain system, the energy at the first move around the energetic anatomy, then go in the chakra or coherence domain, and go in the matter, in the deep layer of the brain. You understand? And this is essential, I think.
I'm going to stop you. I agree with you, and I want to understand better what these coherence domains are, where they are, because I didn't see a picture of those. But I want to say that I've known you for almost a decade, and you're a medical doctor. And I want to ask you, you know, you didn't come into medicine thinking about auras and biofields and coherence domains, but in your work, you worked on your treatment was something that had no matter. You worked on a lesion that was the non-existence of the connection.
Yes.
That's what you did. So you had to come up with a theory on like, how does this work? Because the spinal cord is broken.
Yeah.
So you had to come up with the theory and the solution of the, well, how the heck is this happening? You understand? Am I correct?
Yes. I understand, I think. When I have, for instance, spinal cord injuries, and I irradiate only the spinal cord injuries, I don't have these results. You understand? Because I don't have the possibility to give to the tissue the input for the correct reconstruction of bypass or of the change between glia to functional tissue. If I stimulate full central nervous system, not only the nervous system with the lesion, perhaps the body, the patient with his natural system of regeneration can remake his lesion, or before remake the function after the anatomical lesion, understand?
Correct.
And the function can be returned by the establishment of bypass around the lesion with the inclusion of the nervous system already existing, understand? But when the man, the surgeons, would like to perform some bypass between the, usually the nerve surgeons which put the new nervous system don't have results, because the sutures Institutus line don't allows the transmission of the pulse. You understand? If this bypass is performed in natural manner directly by the patient with the help of the integrator, light is as integrator is vitamins. The integrator given in the right manner in the energetic system, the natural bypass run perfectly. It's not need, it's not essential to have the welding of the lesion. You understand?
Correct. I follow you. So what I see you doing is you're using three or four different lasers of different powers in different times on different areas of the body. So, but what where are you using the you're not using different colors because those are both the infrared and the red and the far infrared. So how are you putting energy into the domain coherence domains? Where are you putting that? Where are you doing the treatment then?
Where is the zone irradiated, or where the zone irradiated are the zone of the coherence domain. That zone are very large. The first three zones are delimited by Russian scientists of Moscow University some years ago, about 10 years ago, but only the first, second, and third coherence domain. The others, no. So when I put the laser in that zone with energy very less and with spot very large. And so I have results at distance. For instance, there is another little but very good application for the treatment of the front in the question of depression, anxiety, or enraged, etc. So we can arrive to influence the psychological state of a person with the same laser, changing the dose. Because when I put in front on the seven on the six coherence domain one laser with pulse very low, the patient have immediately the effect of sedation. You understand?
Sedation.
The anxiety disappear. Here is very very good for about 20 days. If I use the same laser with high frequency, if the patient is calm, the patient after about 30 minutes enraged. I had this experience many times.
Many times. But and so what you're to follow your train of thought is you're saying that you're using a large spot area so that it's not really going to penetrate into the cortex. It's not going to get down deep, but the modulation, the oscillation of the energy is affecting the coherence domains of the body, which then is having its effect.
Yes, we have an effect of bioresonance when we have we have different repetition frequency, different hertz. We give resonance for all the light energy of the body. And so this is good, because in these persons, when we have an important anatomical anatomic lesion, usually the coherence domain are disaligned in physics, are not uniform, not attached one with other. And there is a natural mechanism of the nature of closure of the domain, coherence domain. When we have, for instance, a spinal lesion or brain lesion, the coherence domain of the brain are closed. And this is a mechanism of natural defense for to avoid the exchange wrong energy, of bad energy, for instance, electro negative energy, or also exit of many energy of the body. So the coherence domain is closed. But when the coherence domain is closed, we don't have any hope that the material body can change. Absolutely. Without exchange of energy, we don't have any improvement on the body. And this is one of the things demonstrated by my friend Korotkov, because he studied this from about 50 years.
So, Doc, you've done a great example. What do you see in the future with people being able to utilize this? You've got a lot of gray hair. You look back on this. What do you see happening in 2030, 10 years from this conference? What will they be talking about there? What developments you think are going to be happening? What do you see changing?
I hope that all us can use the same procedures for to optimize the effects of the light are reading now, and to investigate the further effects of the light. And I think that we at this moment have two very good things. At first, we know that exist matter, energy, light, etc. And all the people, the scientists know this. And the second thing is that we can speak together for to have a discussion constructive, to have the possibility to work together to increase the knowledge about this matter. And for this second goal, we must thanks person as you, because it's very, very important the exchange of ideas at all level, not only for vanity or for personal interest, but also for to search together the way, the simpler way for to go ahead in the progress.
Thank you, doctor. Andrò tutto bene. Thank you, Doc.
Okay.